Hello.
Merhaba, ciao, hello.
I'm Jae Kim and here is
Dina.
So I met her today
in Seoul. It's snowing.
Seoul today is snowing a lot. Last time I made video about how is being a Muslim girl in Korea, but she didn't wear hijab. So someone asked me, can you interview Muslim who wear hijab? So I invite her today.
Yay.
Yeah, to ask her questions. Okay, so here we go. 1, 2, 3,
go!
Okay. So first, can you introduce yourself?
Yes. Should I introduce myself the way I do on my channel? Okay. Okay. Assalamu alaikum. Hello. It's your Muslim friend, Dina.
Oh, 이거 너무 좋다, 이거. Hello.
And my name is Dina and I live currently in South Korea and I'm teaching English to elementary schoolers after school in the countryside.
Oh.
And also I make YouTube videos, but I need to do better at that. I will get better.
Fighting. So why did you come to Korea?
I came because I wanted to live in an Asian country since I was younger and I just found the opportunity. I'm teaching through a scholarship program right now.
Oh.
And so I found the opportunity online and I said, you know what? I'm going to go to Korea. I'm just going to go. I like the culture. I like the language and I wanted something different. And so I just went for it. Everyone thought I was crazy, though. My family's like, don't go. It's dangerous.
No,
it's
Korea? Not.
Yeah.
Did they think Korea is dangerous?
Yeah.
Oh.
They're like, don't go, Dina. You're going to die. I'm like, no, I'm not. We're all going to die someday. It's fine.
I get it.
Yeah, no, people were not happy about me going. That's okay. I don't live my life based on everyone else's opinions, so it's okay.
Is there any reason that you're interested in particularly Korea?
Mm-hmm. Well, I liked, ever since I was younger, I've always liked Korea, Japan, and China.
Ah,
I liked
East Asian countries.
Yeah, just East Asian. I like the culture. And I think Korea's culture is the most similar to Bosnia's culture.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
compared to like, it's a little bit easier culturally for me to be here. I mean, I understand like the Chinese and Japanese cultures.
Oh.
It just, this one is more familiar.
Familiar. Oh, that's interesting. So you told me that you're from Bosnia. So have you ever been there?
Yes, I have been to Bosnia. My family's from Bosnia. I was born in Germany and then I moved to the United States of America when I was 5 years old.
So if you know about Bosnia, then can you
introduce Bosnia?
Yeah.
Ah, I think it's a really nice country, especially if you go as a tourist.
Oh.
It's very pretty. If you go to the capital, Sarajevo.
Sarajevo?
Sarajevo, it's the capital. It's really cool because the area was owned historically by two different empires. And so in Sarajevo, like half of the town looks like Austro-Hungarian style, kind of Germany style.
Oh.
And then half of the town is Ottoman Empire, which is like old Turkish Empire, Ottoman Empire.
Oh.
So it's really cool because you can see the different architectures and the different cultures. And then also there's like Bosnian culture mixed in.
Oh.
And then another town that a lot of people like is called Mostar. It's famous for the bridge. It's a really old Ottoman bridge made of stone that goes over this really cool river. And people jump off of it. It's really high. I don't
know
how.
Bridge?
Off of the, it's like 30 meters high or something. I don't know. It's really high. But
<That's>
like, yeah, you have to be part of like the, there's like a diving team or something. I don't know. Because they want to make sure you don't die. So there's like a competition in the summer where people jump off of the bridge.
So it's mixed city.
It's very like mixed when you look at the architecture of the buildings. But people in Bosnia are Bosnians. And then also there's a lot of Croatians and Serbian people in Bosnia. Because all of the whole area, let's say about seven countries, I believe, that used to be part of Yugoslavia. Do you know Yugoslavia?
Yugoslavia.
Yeah, and Yugoslavia broke up.
Yeah, Slovakia, Slovenia.
Yeah, yeah. And so Bosnia was part of Yugoslavia. And because of the breakup, a lot of people are mixed.
That's why.
Because all of us used to be Yugoslavia.
Ooh.
So
I get it.
So it's kind of cool because I can say, oh yeah, I speak like five languages, but they're all just, it's just like Saturi.
So Saturi, I can't speak five languages.
Yeah. I speak Bosnian, I speak Croatian, I speak Serbian, because they're all different countries, but it's really just Saturi. It's really just like, Saturi in English is like a dialect.
Oh.
It's really just dialect. It's like me saying that I speak English and I speak Australian or something. It's like,
you told me it's Korea and Bosnia is familiar. For example, familiar, do you think?
In Korea is more of a family society.
Yeah, right.
Like family oriented.
Mm-hmm.
Bosnia is like that too.
Oh.
America is more individual.
Yeah, right.
Like people leave their families a lot. And Bosnia is very family oriented, and Korea is. And Korea is very like, you know, oppa, like there's the hierarchy. Bosnia has a hierarchy, but not like Korea. Korea is stronger, but Bosnia still has that like respect for elders. In America, people don't really respect elders. In Bosnia, people like respect elders. They're like, okay, yeah, they're like, I gotta make sure to greet the older person. Oh, please take my seat here, let me serve you. Like, it's
so polite.
It's like, yeah, more polite.
So you have lived in America for a long time. So do you think, is there Islamophobia in America?
Yes. Yes, I know there is Islamophobia in America.
Have you ever been discriminated because you're Muslim?
Yes.
Can you tell me about your experience?
I can't tell you about all of them because there's too many. We don't have time. But, so I'm a white person, obviously. But like, I didn't wear hijab my whole life. I started wearing it when I was 14. As soon as I put it on, like, every people around me changed a lot. I got a lot of people like flip me off and like tell me go back to your country and like. And it's like, funny because I'm an American.
When you're American, so yeah. Go
I'm
back
like,
then.
I'm in my country. I'm in my country. It's so funny because here in Korea, I'm a foreigner. But no one tells me to go back to my country. They're always like, oh, thank you for coming to Korea. In America, they're like, go back. And I'm like, I belong here. I'm a U.S. citizen. But yeah, there's a lot of like people on the street like give you really bad looks. Like they glare at you. They're like, why are you here? And I get a lot of people who are very ignorant. They cuss at me a lot, and they flip me off on the street. Yeah.
Because you're Muslim.
Yeah, yeah. People say like, I mean, I'm not gonna say what they say because it's not very nice words. But people at least say things like get out of this country. You're ruining this country. You guys are a bunch of terrorists. Get out, basically. And F you. And they flip. Like it's not everybody.
But it does happen.
Like for me, when I lived in my town in the States, America's huge, so not every place is like this. But in my town, like at least once a week, I had somebody ask me a really rude question, like, so do you like killing people? Or like someone flip me off or telling me to get out of the country or like every week there's like some new instance. So in America I got really like.
So there is like, Islamophobia.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Hard to live. I mean, life is hard. Life is hard.
Yeah, life is
for everybody, okay? It's just a little bit harder when you don't fit in with everybody else. But it's okay. You don't have to fit in with it. See, Koreans, if they don't like me, Koreans don't talk to strangers. So they don't come up to you and say, leave. They just ignore you. But in America, people, they talk to strangers. So they're just straight. Yeah.
Go back to your country.
I'm an American citizen. Look at my passport. That'd be so stupid.
Oh, so it's important question too. I told in my channel hijab is the choice, but someone told me no, hijab is mandatory. So
you wanna know what is?
So I'm confused. So I ask you, do you think hijab is mandatory?
So for sure, 100% hijab is required for men and women. In the Quran, it says men and women have to behave modestly and dress modestly. Those aren't the exact words. But like any law, people choose to follow or not follow the law. So like for example, like when you drive, it's the law to wear a seatbelt, right?
Yes.
But not everybody wears a seatbelt. It's your choice to wear a seat, like it's the law. You need to wear a seatbelt for your own safety. But not everybody wears a seatbelt, right? And that's where you choose. So it is the law to wear hijab. Men and women have requirements. Because hijab isn't, it's not just this. Hijab is also the way you act. And men also have to act modestly with hijab and stuff. But it is, like, it's a law. But every person has the choice to follow the law. So that's where people, that's why people say it's a choice, though it's the law. It is the law, but it's your choice to follow the law.
It's so clear.
Yeah.
It's so clear.
Like, that makes sense.
I understand it. Yeah, all right. Finally, I don't understand. What is that? Wow. So if you think so, then why do you decide to wear hijab?
Kind of a long story. When I was in middle school, I was having like a life crisis. I was like, why do I exist? Why does anyone exist? Do we need to be alive? I was asking, I was like, time to be philosophical.
What is life?
Basically, what is life? And I was like, you know, I thought religion has to be the answer. That sounds better than other options. Mm-hmm. Like Christianity or Islam, one of those has to make the most sense. Mm-hmm. And I was like, Islam makes more sense. And so I'm not the best Muslim ever. I don't follow all of the laws. Mm-hmm. I don't even know all of the laws. But I knew about hijab, and I was like, I felt like a liar within me if I didn't wear hijab in a way. Like, I felt weird saying, oh yeah, I'm Muslim, but I don't pray, and I don't fast, and I don't wear hijab, and I drink alcohol. Like, I felt weird, like, saying, oh yeah, I'm Muslim, but I don't do anything that a Muslim does. I felt, like, for me inside, I felt like a liar, and I couldn't, like, I didn't want to live with myself feeling like a liar. And so I started just because I was like, let me at least try. You know, like, trying is better than not trying at all. And so I was like, let me just at least try. And then over the years, this year is going to be 10 years that I've been wearing hijab. And so, like, over the years, I've just gotten, like, learned more and then gotten more. I should do this. This is why I feel I should do this. I feel like it's, like, a long philosophy talk, but I didn't want to feel like a liar inside. And I figured, hey, you know what? I suck at everything, but let's do that. I can do that. I'll do that.
Oh, I got it. Okay. You're a really good dancer.
A+.
Do not be liar.
Do not be a liar. Yeah, I feel funny.
Next question is, I told you that I interviewed a Muslim before, but she told me there is no Islamophobia, but it's because she didn't wear hijab.
Muslim.
Yeah, they can't figure it out. So you're wear hijab, so do they have any discrimination?
Against me because of hijab? I think many Koreans don't know about Islam.
Yeah, right.
And the only opinion that some people have about Islam is what they see on TV, which is never good. And so some people might have a prejudice or like a bias because of like what they saw on TV. Some people might think, oh yeah, she's Muslim, she's scary. But definitely not like America at all. No one has been scared of me because I'm Muslim. And sometimes Koreans don't know I'm Muslim either.
even you wear hijab?
So people just think I'm a weird white lady. They're like, every other white lady doesn't wear clothes. Why don't you stop wearing clothes too? What's wrong with you? But like, some people do know I'm Muslim. But now that I speak more Korean, I can talk to more people. When I didn't speak Korean at first, people are just kind. Koreans are just generally kind, especially if you come as a tourist. You're really not going to get any discrimination or anything like that, because Koreans, they don't really talk to strangers. And if you're going into a restaurant or a store or something, and obviously you have to interact with the person that works there, they're going to be kind to you, because Koreans are just kind to everyone in general. But now that I know more Korean, and when I'm speaking with more Koreans or meeting more people, I'm noticing a lot more people, they're telling me, oh, when I first met you, I kind of thought you might have been part of ISIS. And I'm like, oh, no, that's not Islam. That's like just because there's a few bad people doesn't mean everybody's bad, right? And so I think Koreans are more curious than anything. And they're not like rudely curious. They're like, they say, because you can be rude and curious. You can be like, so what's wrong with you? Like, that's rude. But like, Koreans are very kind. Most people are like, oh, why do you wear that? Oh, why is that? Oh, where? A lot of people, I went to a kimbap place last week. Right when I come into the door, the guy that works there, he's like, United Arab Emirates.
What?
United Arab Emirates.
UAE.
I was like, no, oh, yeah, I'm American. Migu Saramina. And he was like, Weo? And I'm like, Weo? 그냥 그렇게 됐어요? Like, it just happened like that. He was like, well, why do you wear that? And I'm like, because I'm Muslim. He's like, oh, I didn't know that Muslims could be American. And I'm like, anyone can be Muslim. And so I think really if you come here as a Muslim, just act like in Islam, you should be smiling at people and be being kind to people in general. So just keep doing that.
Yeah, explain.
Yeah, just explain if someone asks you. Most people don't ask me. Like, this happened last week. I've been here for a year. Oh. My first year that I was here, because I didn't speak a lot of Korean, most people didn't talk to me. But if they tried to talk to me, I don't know what they're saying. I was like, smile and nod.
Right.
But if you meet like a person, especially that's in a country that doesn't have a lot of Muslims, you might be the only Muslim person that they've ever met. And so really, like, you shouldn't be stressed out about it. But like, just be kind. Just be you. Be a good person, because that is the kind of impression that they're going to get of you and of Islam. And so really, I think most Koreans are just curious. Like, oh, why do you wear that? Oh, wow. And most people, I don't know. Korea, like, people compliment me all the time. Like, oh, I'm so pretty. So I think Koreans are just nice in general. There's really not a lot of Islamophobia. that I've noticed personally affecting my life. But maybe when I speak more Korean, I can, I don't know. I'll talk to me next year and I'll see you.
Okay, I will ask you next year.
Next year, I'll be like, well, let me tell you. But as a tourist, you're really not going to experience any bad things here, really. Mm-hmm. If you do, it's very, very rare. Congratulations, it's rare. Like, you win. One in a million chance.
Oh, I will ask you about the food in Korea, because in Korea, many foods are based on pork, so how do you figure it out?
I don't eat.
You don't eat?
I'm losing a lot of weight. Well, I did make a video on foods that you can eat that, like Korean foods that you can eat as a Muslim. Mm-hmm. But if you come here as a tourist, you can just look up like different halal restaurants and things like that. When it comes to you live here, if you want to eat meat, I would order online. There's a website called Yes Halal.
Very informative.
And they deliver. I mean, I live in the middle of nowhere and they deliver to my house within like 2 days. And so you can buy meat online and then just like make food at home. Really, I think like you can always make food at home, which is like easy. The harder thing is like when you go out in public trying to find food. But like that's, I made a video on the types of food, Korean food. Kimbap is okay, kind of. You always have to ask to like leave out the spam and the ham and stuff. But like there's different foods. Sujebi is usually okay. Bibimbap. It's really bibimbap. I eat so much bibimbap because
it's like vegetarian food. Bibimbap.
Yeah.
Like vegetables.
Or like fish stuff. Dopbap. Like here, there's a lot of like we're at Sukdae right now. There's a lot of restaurants around here that sell like rice, and then they have like random fish stuff and random vegetables. So you can find. I mean, I'm still alive and I've been here for a year, and I don't eat leaves off the floor. So,
thanks God.
Thank God. I'm also allergic to pork, so I can't. Yeah, I took a blood test. Everyone's like, "How do you know? Did you eat pork?" I'm like, "No," but I took a blood test. I'm allergic, so like if it is in my food, I'm like, "Oh, I'll itchy." I'm like, you said there wasn't any pork. But yeah, you can find food here, and you probably have access to the internet, so look up restaurants.
Can you tell me anything to my subscribers who are afraid to come to Korea because of discrimination, because of hijab?
I would say come to Korea anyway.
Just come.
Just come. The people in Korea are very nice, and especially, I think, is important for people to see the world. If you can come to Korea, then come to Korea and see the world. Don't be afraid. Korea is a very safe country. It's very, very safe.
Yeah.
Probably safer than your country. People do stare, because you're a foreigner, but they don't stare because of hijab. They stare at all the foreigners. So it's like, it's not just you.
Every foreigner stares.
Every foreigner.
Every foreigner I interviewed told me, every Korean is looking at me like,
you're like a unicorn. You're like, ooh. But like it's not the culture to talk to strangers here, so people aren't really going to talk to you, and people are very nice. The people that you do interact with are nice, so I wouldn't be afraid. America was having problems with North Korea, and so that's why my family was like, don't go,
there's nuclear. Kim Jong-un will kill you.
Basically. And I'm like, shit, I'm gonna go anyway, because I'm not going to North Korea, I'm going to South Korea. But like,
it's different.
I know, it's different, but people don't know. They're just like, Korea is Korea.
There's Kim Jong-un.
He's everywhere. Just come. Don't be afraid. Face your fears. Like, come and see how it is. I mean, come and visit. If you're going to live here, maybe visit before so you can see the country. And then go from there. And if you're too scared because coming to Korea is terrifying, maybe do little scary things in your home country to get used to doing scary things. Maybe. Sure. It's really like, look at the good and the bad. And then,
Everywhere.
Choose.
Good and bad things. So, finish. Yay!
Finish!
Yay! So today I interviewed Dina from America, and I hope it's helpful to you if you wonder about being in Korea as a Muslim, especially if you wear a hijab. So thank you for interviewing me. So, so thank you guys, and take care and be safe. Have a good day. So bye bye.
Bye.
Ciao ciao.
Ciao ciao.
Hello.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hello.
I think I did that bad.
I'm done.
안 돼.